And not good for all us Carlton fans. Yeah, that's after the club finally confirmed it sacked coach Brett Ratten despite raging speculation Mick Malthouse will take over next year. Both parties are denying they have even spoken. Jackie Reid joins us from the club.
Brad, we're the last cameras standing here at Visy Park on a remarkable day for the club. Media, cameras and players packed this morning's press conference where the Blues confirmed the league's worst-kept secret, Brett Ratten, had been fired. The decision was made around 2 o'clock yesterday and comes on the back of Carlton's poor loss to the Suns on Saturday night. Mick Malthouse appears the man most likely to take over, but Blues president Stephen Kernahan denies they've made contact with him or his management.
Would Brett Ratten have been sacked if Mick Malthouse wasn't available?
It's a close call, Rob.
Malthouse also kept his cards close to his chest, refusing to answer questions when confronted this afternoon.
Come on, Mick, we're not playing loose games, you know. All right, here we go again.
On the other hand, Ratten was upbeat, keeping the club's decision in perspective.
When I go and look today, when I speak and look at Sam Rowe, who's had gone through cancer, through a season, and you just think, you know, we're going okay.
He'll coach the Blues one last time against St Kilda on Sunday.
I don't need to hide. I need to finish the year and do the job that I was here and put in place to do.
It'll be some farewell, Brad, capping an incredible week in the history of the Carlton Football Club.
Big week, good on you. Thanks very much to Jackie. To the NRL now, and Cronulla chairman Damien Irvine has revealed the club was within days of shutting down. The Sharks have been waiting for approval on a $300 million land development. That approval came from the state government this week, helping to keep Cronulla in the competition.
We never missed a payment, we never missed a wage payment, which we're very proud of, but it all depends on that support of your lenders, and it was literally, very close to being terminal a few times.
Cronulla will now be able to spend all the money in its salary cap. Matt Ebden is the sole Aussie to watch out for in tomorrow morning's singles competition at the US Open. This morning, Leighton Hewitt made it past the first round at Flushing Meadow for the first time in 3 years with a four-set win over German Tobias Kampke, while Sam Stosur celebrated her second round win with none other than LMFAO's Red Foo watching on. Not sure who that is, but anyway.
Every day I'm shuffling.
Most people would know his tunes and they're very catchy, so yeah, it was great to meet him.
You know you've made it when you've got Rockstar sitting in your entourage.
I know, this is a first for me, so it's pretty cool.
Pretty good shuffler. She has a good shuffle.
Good to see a bit of fun there at the US Open. Kim Clijsters' singles career is over after a straight sets loss to Laura Robson. For years, debate has raged who's the best soccer player in the world, Cristiano Ronaldo or Lionel Messi. Well, this morning they faced off. Ronaldo produced this incredible back-heel pass assist to himself. He then slotted Real Madrid's second goal against Barcelona, but not to be outdone, Messi came up with this cracker.
Messi goes for it. Oh, my goodness. What a goal that is.
We still can't split the two. Real ended up winning 2-1 to take out the Spanish Super Cup, but the real superstars of Spanish football can share our play of the day. Now, Lance Armstrong has spoken for the first time since the US anti-doping agency stripped him of his Tour de France titles. He spoke at a cancer summit in Canada, and we think you're going to find this interesting. Have a listen.
I thought in light of recent events, I might ought to reintroduce myself. My name is Lance Armstrong. I am a cancer survivor. I've been asked to come up here and talk about my story of survivorship. I'm a father of five, and yes, I won the Tour de France 7 times. And for those who have no idea what I'm talking about, I love you.
There you go.